One important life lesson we learned from the death of a loved one is that every day is a gift and should be cherished. Live each day and best you could. Auntie, your children believe that you were a special gift from God to us. As we honor here, today from the memory of Nanaya Ajimai, our grandmother, our mother, as we affectionately called Auntie, as everybody called her, we believe that a very big tree has fallen, ripened off the root that provided us shelter. Indeed, for us children, we say, Udupongbi etutu. Ya Baba, Baba sir, we might not understand, but God realized you were getting tired and therefore he wrapped his arms around you and whispered, Yaadepa, come to me to rest. God takes only the best into his beautiful garden. You did not deserve to badly pain or go through enough pain, so he gave you rest. Oh, Yaadepa, you were so loving, caring, respectful by everybody, and we cherish the good time we shared with you. Your sense of humor, unique laughter, welfare impacted in us a qualitative and quantitative change. And we honor you for that constantly required about how we are doing. We say you are our good and great savior. Great savior and advisor. With tears in our eyes, we say thank you for the great values and discipline you intensified in us. Over the years, we will see you again, sleep well in the bosom of the Lord. Nantiye Nanaya, Demri Fredriye, and to rest in peace, Nyamefa Krensi.
Biography. Emma, I'm in the house. Nanaya Ajima, whose body lies before us today, was born on 25th August 1952 at Bremai to Nana Kofi Ajima, the then Jazzy of Bremai, and Oba Penny Yacha, both of blessed memory. She was the 10th child of her father, so she was called Bedu by her colleagues, and also Ahinkai because she was born after his father was ensued. She always say, "I am Ohinba Ya Ahinkai." Until her death on the 14th of January 2022, she was the only surviving sibling of her 11 siblings. She was illiterate because she had a formal education and completed Form 4 Leaver. Nanaya started trading at the Kumasi Kejetia market, precisely Donkomiase, where her mother was. She later met her husband, Mr. Yaosim Numafu, popularly called Esio Bema. They gave birth to 5 beautiful girls, namely Yajanfua, Ekuecha, Abena Kesua, Adua Fuwa, and Ekuya Fumpoma, respectively. Nanaya later settled at home and living idle. She operated a sports electric bar at her residence, Takwamalko. Because of her hard-working nature, she started the trade of clothes and Christmas wear for children during every season. After this period, she eventually retired to stay at home to take care of her grandchildren, as her female children had started becoming mothers. She played this role until her last day. A week prior to 14th January 2022, she complained of not feeling well. She was sent to Comfort Anochi Teaching Hospital for treatment and later gave up a ghost on Friday, 14th January 2022. Apart from her surviving 5 children, she left behind 16 grandchildren and 30 great-grandchildren. Oh, what a sweet mom we had. Mommy, let me feed you. She knew my name.
Tribute by grandchildren, Nananu. Said Nanaya, Ewa and Nananu, Makumako, Dunsia. Almost saying your mo walk a comfort on a honey. Auntie said there will be a friend or no. As we all call her, was a special and a loss of her was felt deeply by many, especially we, the grandchildren. Even though we are kids, we believe that our grandmother has lived a good life. Your grandchildren are heartbroken for your loss, and it is difficult for us to take up to see she is no more. Thank you for your care, concern, love, sacrifices, and everything that you displayed towards us. Rest in peace, Nanaya.
Thank you.